Hello and welcome to Covey Pro Wrestling Nation. Tonight in our main event, Big John Greene will be going 1-on-1 against CEO, a match that we've been actually anticipating for many months. Let's remember that this rivalry got started during summer of 2015 when CEO disrespected the people of Berkeley Springs. Let's take a look.
Let the games begin. Tonight, one of you lucky low-life minions will have an opportunity at something you've never seen in your whole life, which is real money. Take a good look. Juan, why don't you zoom in on that, brother? Look at that. That's real money. That's not a dollar, it's a $100 bill. The question is, who wants to come in this ring with CEO tonight and earn this $100 bill? It's real money. Who wants it? I don't want to hurt your pension, Richie. Have a seat. I tell you who I see. How about that little girl in the audience here with the green hat? Right there. Why don't you come on in? I'll even hold the rope for you so you don't hurt yourself. Don't hurt yourself, we're not insured for you. All right. What's your name?
Connor Godfrey.
Let's give it up for Connor Godfrey. And that's enough for Connor Godfrey. Not by much time. Is this a real $100 bill? You wouldn't know, would you? You've never seen this before in your life. I'll tell you what. Minion in the back, thank you. Minion number one. You want to earn that money? I'm going to put it right here. Keep it safe. All you got to do. Give me that. It's a bouncy ball, real easy. You play, let me ask you, you play sport?
Yes.
What sport do you do?
Baseball.
That's not gonna help you here very much, you know that, right?
Okay. Tell me you're a wrestler too!
What else do you do?
Wrestling.
Wrestling, you're a wrestler. Maybe we should just skip the games altogether and you and I just have a match right here, right now, and you can show me how you wrestle. No. You don't get to do that. All you gotta do is this. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Pretty easy, right? I want all of you, if you can count to 10, Richie, I know you can't, but if you can count to 10, Richie, you can barely count to 3. If you can count to 10, I want you to count along with Connor as he does this. Come in the middle of the ring, take this ball, you bounce it 10 times without messing up, you get $100. Let's count. It starts right now. Go ahead.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10.
Oh my. Goodness, that was so amazingly close. I can't even believe that. That is such a shame. I can't fall. Oh, I'm so sorry. I'm not sorry at all, because it's my money and I earned it. You didn't. So how about you get out of my ring? Let's give a big hand for Connor since he lost so pitifully. Get out. Out.
It's all right.
Is there anybody here in Berkeley Springs? Anybody? Who has any skill at all that wants my money?
I wanna see you with your mind. I wanna see you with a broken day.
Are you lost, son? You know where you are? This is my ring. This is my show. You sound like you have something you want to say to me. Go ahead, say something.
Why do you come down here to Berkeley Springs and mess with all these people? Nobody here likes CEO.
Everybody likes CEO.
You white-collar, decent crap, son. You come down here, You cheat a little kid out of some money.
And you think Berkeley Springs loves you.
Cheat? I didn't cheat anybody. I can't help it if you didn't earn that money. Is that what you want? The blue-collar bimbo, the homeless adventure that you are, sticking around the back? You want me to give that little girl money? Why? Why? Because she earned it when she earned it. She earned my disrespect. She earned a seat next to her grandmother in the hat there. That's what she earned.
That's what she earned. You a guy that likes to play with five aces up his sleeve, right?
I got all the cards.
You think you got all the cards?
I'll
tell you what. Watch you try that with me.
You what with you?
Why don't you try that with me, son? Pull out your fifth ace, not your stinking teeth.
Look, you're about to write a check that your body can't possibly cash. Boy. You are an OLDMAN and I am an OFK CEO, and that makes you an LOSER. Let's see if they can. You can YouTube that so you can actually understand what I just said. You want CEO? Is that what you people want to see? You want to see Big John Green CEO right here, right now?
Don't mess the suit up!
Why don't you stand up on talking to you?
See every Covey Pro show going all the way back to the beginning on September 23rd, 2006 with bonus footage and original shows, original programming, and at all costs
for
a month. Go to CoveyProWrestling.PivotChair.com and get the Covey Pro Network for
tonight or any other night. You put me on your flyer and you don't pay me to be here. You don't give me a match. I'm not giving these people anything for free. Walk away while you still can.
Well, you know, John Greene, he asked for it. He came out here asking for it.
I'll tell you, he's really working the leg of John Greene there. And I don't know. What's he got there? He's hitting him with something, some kind of foreign object.
I think that's the first time you've ever seen a foreign object, Bruce.
Well, I can only call him when I do see him there, Donnie.
Well, to be honest, I was worried about you being able to see from up here, but so far, so good.
He's definitely working on the foot of Dr. John. We need to get somebody out here to help him.
No, we don't. John wanted this. John asked for this.
Yeah, see, Acevedo attacking from behind. John wasn't expecting that.
He should have been expecting it with the smack he was talking. You don't stand toe-to-toe with CEO and expect to walk away after talking to him like that.
I tell you, that can't be good for John.
And speaking of walking away, I don't think John's gonna walk away. John wanted to come out here. He's the champion of the people. He wants to take up for the
dreads. Oh, he's in a figure four right around the ring post there.
That is not going to be good for John Greene at all.
I'll tell you, unfortunately, John's going to be walking funny in the morning and not for good reasons.
Let's see if he can even walk. But wait a minute. CEO didn't go away. He's coming back with chairs.
Oh, my. Chairs are never good. Anybody involved.
I tend to enjoy them very much, as long as they're nowhere near me.
Come on, we need to get somebody out here. We need to get someone out here to help John and quick.
No, I'm enjoying this myself.
Well, you would enjoy it, Johnny.
Of course. Oh!
Oh, my.
I think he broke the other chair. And again, look at that. Oh, and across the ankle. That knee, that ankle.
Boy, I'll tell you, we definitely need to get somebody out here to help John. This is just disgusting. This is way further than it should have ever gone.
This is great. What are you talking about?
Oh, come on, he's defenseless.
You know what, Bruce? If you want to stop it so bad, how about you go down and stop it?
I would if I could. I'm not a trained wrestler like these guys are. And I'm certainly not going to get in the ring with them without my striped shirt on, because they're not going to listen if I have to hurt him.
I don't think they're going to listen to anything anybody has to say now. I don't know if John's ever going to walk again.
I'm not sure about that.
He is.
Aren't there any other wrestlers in the back that even care what John's
doing?
There's
no security
out here, at least.
Security trying to stop him. It's security. One security guy. The one security guy is brave enough to get in there.
We got a second security guard out here waiting.
He's complaining. He doesn't want to get in there.
Now there's referee Bill Jacobs.
There's Bill.
And Charles Stevenson. Head ref Charles Stevenson is out here as well.
And some words for the security guard that's now laid out. John's is he either trying to hobble away out or hobble back in.
Oh wow, Bill just set him down.
And it's taking. What is he doing? Did he just shove? He shoved something in the security guard's mouth.
The refs are trying to get the situation under control.
Is that a pink slip? Did he put a pink slip down his throat? He just terminated the security guy.
Does he have the power to do that?
Evidently he does. Or he just did. Nobody else is going to stop him.
I didn't think he was the CEO of Covey.
At this point, he's the CEO of whatever he wants to be.
Yes, CEO! 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 I'll tell you, people with money just think they can do whatever they want around here.
Can you believe this?
Many people thought that we would not see Big John Greene for a long time after that attack from CEO, but the month after, at the Dave Duncan Tag Team Memorial Tournament, Big John Greene made a return, and these two men crossed paths again. Let's take a look.
It's their daily nightmare, money talks. He doesn't have to be pretty to be dangerous.
The CEO brings out another newcomer too, and his son's Capri. The valet.
There's a collar and elbow.
Oh wow, there's the strength of that monster. He doesn't say much.
CEO doesn't spend his money unwisely. He had a plan with this man.
Well, so far it's paying off.
They definitely improved the view in this town, bringing in a sans capri.
Keep your eyes on the match there, Donnie.
Trying to, a little difficult. Oh, wow. And here comes John.
Double team action in the corner. John trying to break it up.
Oh, Richie's right on top of things. Speaking of right on top of things, and look, just a crazed look in his eyes. He doesn't care.
Most difficult thing about a tag match, keep in order. And you're absolutely right, this big monster CEO's doesn't seem to show, doesn't seem to care at all. Tag in the CEO.
Well, now CEO's got a chance to work over Doughboy and those big knees to the ample breadbasket.
Oh, there's no love lost between John Greene Justice or Big John Greene CEO.
No. All three of these men have had infamous battles in CEOs. Big leg drop. And another one.
Third time's a charm.
And now tagging back into that monster, Luke Butler.
Searing the rights to the midsection of John Boy Justice. Here comes an Irish whip.
Oh, caught him sleeping and he took the monster down.
Look at the left. Only two. When John Boy's coming at you that quick, you're going to fall. There's nothing you can do.
Well, John Greene coming in now to work over to the monster and working him over to the knees, but
he just fed him straight back to CEO. He wants a piece of CEO.
Well, CEO's not going to give him what he wants.
Those overhand chops hurt so bad.
Look, CEO's not going to take the tag. He's sending the monster back in, and look. He likes it. And he's back, Johnny, despite John nailing him with knees, and now he's working over John's ribs. And
just bowling through those knee strikes.
Oh, look at that. Showing no respect to Richie White.
Bad call, brother. If there's one man in this building you don't want to brawl with, it's Big John Greene. Through the tag out CEO, and a trip from Mr. Capri.
No.
Yes.
No. Doughboy fell.
Well, he mysteriously got his leg caught in her hand.
I'll buy that one.
Stomped him back from CEO.
I was thinking maybe the, big PDT.
Short trip, bad landing, brother.
Wow. John Greene puts five across the eyes as CEO.
And CEO just fed out. He wants Big John Greene.
Well, now he's working over John Greene and holding him there for that monster Nutler.
The Hillbilly Nightmare.
Oh, look, John's double DDT.
All that weight coming down on your neck does him no good.
And it looked like John was trying to power through both of those guys to get to the tag.
John took that turnbuckle hard.
This is not going to end well.
Corner splash from Nutley. And right back into CEO's corner. This monster, this hillbilly nightmare has paid dividends. And a big slam.
You know, I can smell him from here. That looks like he's dazed in months.
Attempt to defend the door. A boot to the face for his troubles.
Oh, caught Doughboy sleeping on the outside. Another big leg drop. Oh, Richie White's been right on. Oh, gator roll.
Good officiating, but Richie hasn't lost a step.
And a cheap shot from Big John Greene.
Wound up European uppercut.
Here we go. Oh, come on!
Here comes
hey, Richie,
the rat.
What are you doing?
What?
Charlie Brown is holding him there. Charlie Brown just hit him.
I didn't see a thing, brother.
Of course you didn't see a thing.
I just saw John Boy Justice hit a big uppercut on CEO.
Yeah, we admit Charlie Brown just punched CEO. He held him there.
I never held him.
I didn't see him touch a man.
Of course not.
You tell him, Charlie, you didn't touch that man.
Well, that's fine, because after this, I'm hoping CEO choke slam through the ring.
Big clothesline from Nutter.
This Nutter guy's.
We're covering hook of the leg.
Oh. Oh, yeah, you don't touch the merchandise, John.
This is breaking down here, Donnie.
Oh, you just found out his son's Capri. That kitten's got claws, John.
Swift Justice in the ring.
Oh.
And there's a three.
Wow. Just like that, and now look. John's got CEO. Nutter out.
Just bouncing CEO's head
off the ring. John Boy Justice and King John Greene.
CEO, they're... Look like that. Oh, he's got Charlie, all right. He just ripped Charlie's shirt off and...
You better watch out there, CEO. Charlie Brown in a bit scared to slap you upside the head.
I was hoping to see that.
Justice was served that night, and Big John Greene was able to get some retribution on CEO. But this was far from over. Nation, it's time for a quick commercial break, but we'll be right back.
Hello, Covey Pro Nation. This is Big John Greene. Hey, have you ever thought about becoming a professional wrestler, a referee, a ring announcer? If you want to get in on the action, come on down. Give us a call at 304-298-2192 or 240-421-1938. Join us at our Covey Pro Dojo for training for you to become a professional. We're located right behind the Earth Dog Cafe on 522 in beautiful downtown Berkeley Springs.
Hello again, you're watching Covey Pro Wrestling and Nation. Right now, I got exciting news for all of you concerning our next live show. It will be taking place on January 30th of 2016 at the Covey Pro Sportatorium in Berkeley Springs, West Virginia. Right now, I'll leave you with the full card for this event. It was actually a couple weeks ago that we found out that Chris Wilde will be getting a shot at the Covey Pro Heavyweight Championship during Unchained 2016. But it was until last week that we found out who his opponent will be between Crazii Shea and Bodysnatcher. Let's find out right now what happened in our Covey Pro Rewind.
Bit difficult to see from this angle.
Shea's got to get that arm free before he can do anything here.
And I don't think the fans quite know which way to go at this point. Shea trying to get back to his feet.
Sure, and a lot of power from Crazii Shea being able to get up with that man's weight on him. karate kick from Crazii Shea.
They're taking a page out of Napalm's book.
Drop kick to the upper shoulder, put the body snatcher down.
And the lunatic is starting to get up on the ring. We've seen her used as a weapon more times than...
Here comes the lunatic.
Yep. Well, wouldn't be the first time we've seen this. Lunatic's gonna be used as a weapon again.
And down goes the body snatcher. Shea showing no regard for the lunatic's health there.
Well, not the first time we've seen it in a lot of states. I think that would be considered somewhat of a domestic violence type situation, but...
Shea's just picked up a woman and used her as a weapon.
Yeah, but she's as crazy as he is. We all knew that. Now she just disappeared. That kind of worries me.
Shea set up for the acai moonsault. Double knees to the head of the body snatcher from an acai moonsault.
And both men down. The lunatic reappeared from wherever she was hiding. Shea, that's not the same crazy look. That is a really sick, sick, crazy look.
Shea just keeps the body snatcher a case of knee collapse. This is the clothesline.
You know, Oh.
Choke bomb from the body snatcher.
You know, I keep going back to it. I keep saying it, but if you've seen the old Shea, if you've well, there may not be a Shea left, so I can cut it off right there.
Tremendous guillotine leg drop from body snatcher. Down to hook the leg. Shea slid out the back door.
But you know, Chris, to go back to what I was saying, if you've seen the old Shea, if you got the Covey Pro Network, only $4.99, you can go back and watch matches, I think, all the way back to 2008 right now. So you look at the old Shea, you look at the looks that he gave, those crazy, crazy looks before something horrible was about to happen. These are not the same looks.
Oh, absolutely, Donnie. Bobby said, this is a guillotine leg drop this time. This is a new crazy Shea. We've seen him in the past. We see what he may want to do. We see he comes to the Sabu School of Wrestling. My ass means nothing to me. But this Shea is sick, twisted, demented, and gone, and he's on fire.
Nothing good can come from this. He's sitting,
literally dousing his hand and fist in fire.
This cannot go well. He's down.
Snatcher, stay down. Trust me, you don't want any of this.
Shea. Snatcher, you might want to get out of there now.
Snatcher,
Shea waiting. Don't turn around, man. Don't turn around. He just set his hand on fire.
Flaming hard punch from crazy Shea. What the hell, man?
I told you, if half the things that this man told me he was gonna do happen in this match, nobody's safe.
Hook the leg from Shea. Body snatcher reaches the ropes.
What more do you have to do to kill that man?
What the hell's wrong with Shea? I understand wanting to win a match, but there's such a thing as going too far.
What's wrong with body snap? Why would you kick out of that? A man set himself on fire and punched you in the heart. Why would you want any more?
I can honestly say I have no idea, Donnie.
What next?
The man's getting up. And look at that look on Shea's face.
I told you he's sick. Oh. Down goes the ref, and that's not going to go well for, not going to go well for body snatcher at all.
Body snatcher got a rake to the face. The referee ended up basically getting DDT.
Shea's got something. Like a kid sneaking exactly a Christmas present.
Body snatcher, don't do it. He's taking a page out of my book. Don't do it. Snatcher, no!
He's baiting him. Look at that.
He's taking a page out of my book.
Wow. Hook, line, and sinker. And now he's got a chair.
Come on, Jay! A chair?
Jay, what about these people? You hear this?
You've got enough, Jay!
Half of them are cheering, half of them are booing. I don't know what's going on anymore, neither do they.
Bodies have to stay down, man!
He's not gonna. Too proud, too strong. What? Really?
Seriously, Shay?
Well, I don't know. I really don't know what to say about the outcome of that match. We saw a flaming heart punch, a spear into a loaded belly, and you end it with a Guerrero?
Flaming fist, going too far. The plate to the midsection, a little twisted, I've been there. And finish it. You've done all that damage to the man, and you go for a Guerrero special to kill it. Oh, Bodysnatcher's not having it, and Shay better run like hell.
Also, last week, Chris Wilde sent this message to Crazii Shea.
See, ever since I've came into Covey Pro, there's been one thing that has eluded me. One thing that has eluded me. I've been to promotions all up and down the East Coast. I've been in the most prestigious tournaments. I've won some of the oldest championships. But I've never touched Covey Pro Gold. Now, if you're paying attention, there's been a lot of controversy surrounding those titles. Tonight, I proclaim that the next time you see the heart of the Heart Killer, there's going to be some gold around it.
Let's not forget that these two men were actually tag team partners at one point, so it will be very interesting to see what will happen between them on January 30th. Nation, it's time for a quick commercial break. We'll be right back. Still to come in our main event, Big John Greene will be taking on CEO.
See every Covey Pro show going all the way back to the beginning on September 23rd, 2006 with bonus footage and original shows, original programming, and at all cost
$4.99
a month. Go to CoveyProWrestling.Pivotchair.com and get the Covey Pro Network for
$4.99
a month. CoveyProWrestling.Pivotchair.com.
On January 30th, Covey Pro Wrestling will be presenting the first live show of 2016. Let's take a look at the full card so far. The first match that was actually announced for this show was the triple threat match for the Covey Pro Women's Championship between Nyla Rose, the returning Kelly Klein, and the champion Maria Menounos. We actually talked to Nyla Rose the night that she lost the title to Maria Menounos, and this is what she had to say.
I was robbed, plain and simple, from day one since I've stepped into Covey Pro. Every corner I turn, I get robbed. It's like I'm walking around in a bad neighborhood or something. It was a long time coming for me to get the title. I got the title, great, robbed. It's a long time coming for me to get the title back, got the title back, great, robbed. A second time, a second time, I came out on top amongst all the cheaters and lowlifes and just, what's the Christmas season? The ho-ho-hos. Here at Covey Pro, and I got my title back, becoming a three-time Covey Pro Women's Champion. And yet again, I was robbed.
Oh, going for a slam on Nyla, gets her up.
Ichinoku driver from Marie Manic, under the leg.
She got her.
That's what happened in the ring.
In the ring, Nyla Rose, the old Women's Champion, is never coming back to take that belt again. And she's got a steel chair. Out with the old, in with the new. There's your new queen. And she's making sure Nyla has her proper send-off. Wait a minute! No, that's Kelly Klein!
I was pretty shaken up. There's no secret. Miss Klein and I have a little bit of a history. She's a veteran of Covey Pro, if you will. So I was a little shocked to see her come to my aid. Just as quickly as she came in, she left. I have no idea what that was about. Thanks to modern technological marvels. I'm gonna shoot a little Facebook message. I'm gonna follow her on the Instagram. I'm gonna send out a tweet or whatever these kids are doing nowadays. I'm gonna get in touch with Miss Kelly Klein. Not that I'm ungrateful. I'm just curious as to why she was so nice to me tonight. Because it seems here at Covey Pro, I can't trust anyone.
So far, we have not heard from Kelly Klein, but we'll try to have a statement from her next week right here on Covey Pro TV. Nation, the time for the main event has arrived. And as you can see right now, CEO is already making his way to the ring. Tonight, he'll be facing Big John Greene on a match that has many months in the making. Big John Greene versus CEO is next. Hello, Covey Pro Nation. This is Big John Greene. Hey, have you ever thought about becoming a professional wrestler, a referee, a ring announcer? If you want to get in on the action, come on down. Give us a call at 304-298-2192 or 240-421-1938. Join us at our Covey Pro Dojo for training for you to become a professional. We're located right behind the Earth Dog Cafe on 522 in beautiful downtown Berkeley Springs.
Hey, folks, this is Cody Covey with Covey Pro Wrestling, and I'm here to tell you that the Covey Pro Network is up and running via Pivot Share. See every Covey Pro show going all the way back to the beginning on September 23rd, 2006, with bonus footage and original shows, original programming, and at all costs.
$4.99
a month. Go to CoveyProWrestling.PivotShare.com and get the Covey Pro Network for
Oh, wow.
The There's no love lost between these men, but there's sure to be blood shed between them.
Oh, no. And Big John Greene has been really, really mad for a long time. He's wanted to get his hands on CEO. I think we all saw what he did barging into Cody Covey's office, demanding this match, verbally assaulting the boss. He didn't care if he got fired. He, one way or another, he wanted to get his hands on CEO.
Nobody goes head up on a boss like that. But John wasn't ready to do this. But the CEO's taking it to him. Big John may have made a mistake.
Oh, now John knows. Now John knows exactly what he asked for. One of these guys isn't walking out of here tonight.
Big shoulder block from CEO.
Oh, the aggression. Already, and do you hear it? Sounds like he's punching a side of beef. Just now, John's locked it in.
Head and arm judo throw from John. Only two.
Wow. Now an elbow drop from John Greene, and another one for good measure.
Nothing fancy about it, brother. Big air from a big man. There's a cover. There's a hook and leg.
The CEO is having none of that. Remember, this man is a one percenter. He is the once and future king. The man with the Midas touch, CEO.
These men have been laying into each other, and neither one of them seems to even care.
The CEO's not happy about it either. CEO wants to break Big John Greene. He wants to hurt him just as bad as John Greene wants to hurt CEO.
CEO's calling him out. Straight up to his face, calling for a chop fest.
Oh. And you just hear him.
So easy to throw the blood to the surface with one of them. You can split a man easily. Here comes Eric Whip.
Block it. And now some hammering clotheslines of his own by John Greene.
And a hip roll takeover from John, butts on the ropes.
Wow.
That may have been the only thing to save CEO there.
And another elbow from John Greene.
We always talk about how John is a great brawler. He's a lot more technically sound than we actually give him credit for.
Yeah, we don't often see that side of John Greene. But I don't think John Greene really wants to outright brawl with CEO.
John usually doesn't have to tap in on the technical side of him. But tonight, he's pulling out all the stops to CEO.
Well, we've seen quite a bit out of CEO, too, and a man that signs as CEO. And now CEO with a block of his own, spin around, drops him on his head with a big DDT. Good night, John.
Beautiful swing through. You know me, Donnie, I'll give credit where credit was due. That was beautifully done by CEO.
It was. And you talked about the technical skill, how about the brains of that man, CEO?
And there's the full Nelson.
Yeah, that may be it. I mean, John, you see John trying to get that center of gravity low. He's trying to push him back, trying to break those big fingers in that vice-like grip, and now throwing the elbows in. Uh-oh. Trying to hook him.
He's got a hook.
Now a big reverse DDT.
Wall Street crash. Hook of the leg. Only two.
Well, I thought that was it.
Usually that's a kill.
And it still could have been, but John's running on pure hate and adrenaline at this point.
That move's the best of both worlds. An inverted DDT and a neck breaker combined.
And John's still down, though.
I can understand why CEO's confused. Usually that is a three.
And it still should have been. I just think the ref might have been a little slow on it. I mean, he's defending his case.
CEO's got to stay focused. You don't want to give John time to breathe.
Well, John trying to fight his way back.
Series of shots to the midsection from Big John Greene.
John trying to splay him out over that rope, and now another big chop.
One more Olympic chop. Let him go, blood on the surface.
Well, there may still be some diesel in that old tank.
You can hear that echo throughout the building. And the fans are calling for another.
Well, John's awake now. And CEO is definitely, definitely filling those.
There's Aaron Quip. Driving clothesline from John Greene.
Now John Greene talk a little smack to CEO. And you know, you said it about John Greene, it's the same thing. You don't want to give CEO a chance to breathe. He's almost put you away already.
John's staying focused and staying on the man with a series of kicks and a knee strike to the side of the head.
And John still talking trash, telling him, come on, son, I don't know that you really want to be Goden. A man the size of CEO and a man as dangerous as CEO.
Here's the Iron Quip.
Big boot.
CEO countered Clinton Town with a big boot to the face.
And he is calling for it.
Look at those welts forming on that man's chest.
Look at the face. Look how angry he is.
We got him up. Lines it up. Big slap.
That's it. That's it. CEO takes it, and you know what, Chris? He did it clean. And that's got to eat John Greene alive that CEO was able to beat him and do it clean. No underhanded tactics, right in the middle of the ring.
Credit given where due. You're absolutely right, Donnie. Clean as a whistle. It was a hell of a contest between the two men. Both of them, we've seen so much aggression tonight from these men. And here comes the traditional CEO calling sign, the pink slip, crammed down the throat of Big John Greene. More insult to injury than anything else.